With this, I would like to hand over the introduction to Oswin, who is one of the first people who had started this patient self-help organization. And Oswin, you want to introduce yourself and start with it?
Yes, sure. Thank you, Dr. Prashant, for the delightful introduction. And a very good evening to all the distinguished panelists and attendees of this webcast comprising of PHOs, caregivers, doctors, and well-wishers. Going back in time, I was about 8 years old when I heard my doctor ask my mother, "Was I born blue?" She replied in the negative, but then added that I was born with a hole in the heart. As far back as I can remember, every time I developed a symptom or temperature, when we went to the doctors, they would always pose these type of questions. Moving forward, the terminology HTTP is a synonym of this very concept, where we hope to turn pink, especially basically in the pink of health. Those with PH are either born blue or develop the rare disease at a later stage. Our HTTP journey began about 12 years ago through a Google forum. Today we have about large many numbers in our WhatsApp group, with a few gone to eternal abode over the years. Every time a new PHO or caregiver joined our group, the one thought which comes to us is, how do we welcome, how do we greet the person? The question that hurts us the most is, can we say glad to have you with us? We nevertheless gladly welcome them, as we feel our journey is long, may not be short. Even if so, we'll never be short of joy, peace, and cheerfulness. Going forward, our vision for HTTP is to help every PHO in India and the subcontinent through the HTTP Foundation. Here is where we need a lot of support from all quarters, which aims to include professionals, doctors, PH associations, including PVRI, PHOs, caregivers, research scientists, and pharma companies. The advantage of operating in this organized manner is we can identify doctors who have significant knowledge and expertise in this field, living in various states of the country. I knew a young 21-year-old PHO who succumbed due to lack of information by experimenting on stem cell therapy. Our foundation, therefore, to be informative and a platform of recommendation so that we don't make mistakes. With the funds from the charity, we can fund PHOs' medication and consultancy visits. We also hope to fund PHOs for their transplants. The cost of a transplant today is about $60,000, close to around 50 lakhs Indian rupees, including incidentals, which is simply unaffordable. I knew a 26-year-old PHO who succumbed in the process of collecting funds for transplant. We hope to find funding for this noble cause. We have everything with us: willpower, energy, enthusiasm, and above all, we have hope. The only thing we don't have is time, and therefore we are in a tearing hurry. Lastly, I would like to add, as a PHO myself, that I have lived life to my fullest without compromises, played soccer, rappelled about 100 meters down a mountain. In fact, the climb up, back up took almost my life. I have done paragliding in the hilly regions of Manali. Happy to state that I even underwent helicopter training and did an hour of helicopter flying in the US, in New York. Of course, with a trainer alongside. I also believe PH is not hereditary. My two sons, aged 14 and 16, are professional footballers. My older son played for the state team, was also chosen for nationals. To end my talk, I would say I'm not a PH patient, never lived as one, never will be a PH patient. We are individuals living with PH, basically PH survivors. I am a PHO. So thank you once again, Dr. Prashant, for the opportunity for working together with PVRI for a bright future, and look forward to a long association. Thank you.